Well, good evening. First up tonight, Matildas captain Sam Kerr has fired back against trolls who have targeted teammate Ellie Carpenter with vile online abuse in the wake of Wednesday's World Cup defeat. Our golden girl leaping to the defence of her teammate just a short time ago. While millions across the nation have only respect and admiration for the Matildas, some cowardly critics have been so vicious in their attacks, Carpenter has been forced to restrict her social media.
It's a slow-motion replay that Ellie Carpenter will likely replay in her moments of personal torment.
Australia have made a hash of it. Lauren Hemp has put England back in front.
About 70 minutes into Wednesday's semi-final, losing the one-on-one contest, giving England's Lauren Hemp the opportunity to boot the ball into the corner of the net and reclaim the Lionesses' lead.
I'm a big fan of Ellie, but that was a colossal mistake, a game-changing mistake from her not to deal with that, and Hemp was there to pounce.
But unlike the critical post-game commentary from professionals, the trolls have been unfair and unrelenting. We've chosen not to show the abusive posts, but it's prompted loyal Tillys fans, both old and new, to jump to the aid of their Aussie hero.
The good thing about playing a team sport is it's never one person's fault, or it's never one person that made the team win, and I think without Ellie, our whole team, I mean, Tony probably tell you, our whole team plan probably changes. She's such an amazing player for us.
Teammates at today's A-League launch, also at the defenders' defence.
Look, it's really hard and we're trying to tell her not to look at all that stuff, which she already knows. Every single person left their heart and soul on that field, and Australia should be proud, and no one should be ever turning around and criticising players for trying their best.
The thing about being among Australia's best, these athletes are exposed to the absolute worst. But the messages of love are far louder than the trolls, and this is a team that's claimed hearts around the country.
You can sense the excitement in the team today from being very hurt emotionally after the last game, which I think the Swedish team was as well. It's about using those emotions and channeling them the right way to use as fuel going into the game tomorrow.
Paris Martin for 10 News First.